And a good day, everyone. Jewel here with you for J7409 weather as we check out what is going on with tropical weather. What you're looking at, of course, is Invest 91L. Currently, right now, the winds are 20 knots. There's no gust indicated. The minimum central pressure is 1,007 millibars. Radiation of circulation is 120 nautical miles, and the radiation of maximum wind from this is 70 nautical miles. Now, folks, recent GFS runs have taken the system towards the Mexican mountains, and it looks like there's where, according to the GFS run, it should deposit most of the moisture in Mexico before drawing the remaining moisture northward into the deep south. Now, the recent European readings tend to track the system near or just off northern Mexico, then toward up into the West Gulf Coast, and the circulation doesn't seem to be growing any. Now, the Canadian model, we got so many models, it has the most convective solution, I should say. It's looking like with the eastern most extra track, the system on the Canadian model is showing the system to be much faster and much stronger along the Texas coast, probably by Wednesday, and then across Louisiana on Thursday. But when you put all of these together, and then you go and you check out things at the National Hurricane Center itself, it seems that the National Hurricane Center seem to be favoring today the system to dissipate. That's good news. It should dissipate over Mexico. Will it or won't it? We'll have to wait and see. It's got a lot of high pressures around it, folks. Going to squeeze the life out of it and not let it go very far. As I showed you yesterday, I really think it's going to go up like this. But I think the system's, it's just going to be a huge rainmaker. That's what I think right now. I may change my mind, but according to the National Hurricane Center, here we go. Let's push this up a little bit so you can see it all for yourself. This is a low-pressure system. It's located over the southern bay of Campeche. It's producing disorganized showers and thunderstorms as of now. Now, this system is expected to move slowly west-northwestward toward the coast of Mexico, and it could become a tropical cyclone before it moves inland early next week. Regardless of development, the disturbance will likely produce heavy rainfall over portions of southern and eastern Mexico during the next few days, and an Air Force Reserve reconnaissance aircraft is scheduled to investigate the disturbance later today if it becomes necessary. Now, interest along the Gulf Coast of Mexico should monitor the progress of this system. 2 days, 5 days, potato, patata, doesn't matter. You have a 60% chance of this developing into something 2 days and 5 days ahead. Now we have a look at the GFS map, the latest run this morning, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. Now, folks, I showed you that system yesterday. I said, don't get too upset. We'll have to watch it and see what happens. Well, I always watch these things to see if they stay or if they go or whatever. Well, it stayed through the 6 a.m. run, the 12 p.m. run, the 6 p.m. run, all of those runs. It stayed, but it moved. Okay, remember, it first looked like it was coming up here off the Carolina coast. Well, it moved over and looked like then it was going up into the Florida Panhandle. Then it moved a little more. These high pressures that are going to be showing up over here later in this map, I'm just going to turn this on and let it run while I talk to you right quick. That is what is going to change it. And this morning, it's not showing up at all. Of course, today is Sunday, the 2nd of June, 2019, the second day of hurricane season. doesn't mean something else might not pop up later. But right now, I'm going, yay, yay, thank you, Jesus. I don't want it to show up. Doesn't mean it might not pop back up, though. So, gotta watch the tropics real close right now. And as you can see, as time marches through, the system from 91L is looking like it's going to go up and bring much, much rain to many, many people that really does not need it at all as it marches on through and out. We'll have to wait and see what happens with that, but this is the latest run of the GFS right here, and nothing is showing up at this time like it did yesterday for the Gulf here or the Carolina coastlines. Now, where will it go? What will it do for Invest 91L? Well, we're not quite sure, but this is what it's looking like. Here's some of the tracks, the spaghetti models for the different tracking models going on right here. Personally, I think I may change my mind, but I'm looking more or less like right now. I think that you see the TVCN track. This model has never let me down. It's a pretty good tracker. So, if we go by that model, we have so many, this isn't half of them, but these are the major ones, okay? If we come down here and we follow this track, it shows you the hours that it's in. Looking like it is going to come into Mexico, and it's probably going to dump a lot of rain, but still have a lot of rain clusters that could contain convection in them to cause severe thunderstorms, much, much rain where is not needed, as it does push up into Texas and on up across, as you can see. We'll wait and see if it takes us track or not. This is what it's looking like right now, though. That seems to be a pretty logical picture of what may happen. But it can change, as we all know. But that's what the tropic is looking like today with 91L. Everyone keep your eyes on it. And I hope everyone in the Gulf Coast states, as well as the East Coast states, are prepared for hurricane season. I hope you have your kits together. I hope you have your plans together. If you don't, you very well need to do so. Check your insurance papers. All of that stuff you know you need to do. You need to go ahead and do it. This hurricane season is beginning to remind me of what I said in my very first hurricane forecast for 2019. We've got to watch these systems, folks, because just like yesterday, I watched that on the GFS and I also showed it to you. It blew up. That's what I'm afraid is going to happen. Do not depend on El Nino to save you and not have hurricanes this year, because it's just about fizzled out completely. So don't count on that saving you from not having hurricane threats, okay, or tropical storm threats. Go ahead and get prepared now. If these storms do occur, what saved us from that one showing up yesterday? High pressure. May not always have a high pressure. Looks like they're going to blow up, folks. So, please keep that in mind and go ahead and prepare, okay? And that's your tropical update for today. If I see any big major changes, I will be sure and get it up for you. Don't forget to subscribe and click that bell. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day, and peace, love, and kindness to each of you. Thank you so much for watching and sharing.